Hello everyone, again we are back with a new topic and a new video. So the word intelligence, most of us use frequently this word and familiar with this word, but the problem is most of us don't know the proper meaning of it. So what does that mean? So intelligence means the ability to learn. When I say ability to learn, it means it includes two things. The first one is curiosity and the second one is cognitive ability. Without these two things, we cannot learn anything. The second one is problem solving quality. Ability of problem solving means when a problem occurs, how you are dealing with it, how your attitude towards the problem is the main thing. The third one is analytic ability of the mind, means the ability to collect all the information and then thoroughly analyze that to solve that problem is the third thing. The fourth thing is to apply the acquired knowledge. For example, in the 2 years of BA program, the teacher trainees first learn how to handle the students, how to teach them. After becoming teacher, they apply all the acquired knowledge in the teaching profession. Many of the psychologists also give their opinion about what is intelligence. The first, for example, according to Piaget, intelligence is the ability to adapt to one's surroundings. Whereas Wagner considers intelligence as the capacity of your learning and how you are adjusting to a new and repeatedly changing situations. Thurston also gave his opinion about intelligence. Louis, so today my group is going to present the Thurston's primary mental ability theory. So Louis L. Thurston was an American psychologist. He is famous for his contribution for factor analysis theory. Now the question is, what is factor analysis theory? So the factor analysis theory is a statistical method used to find out the correlation between different variables. Firstly, it is used by Spearman, but Thurston did the further development. Now my colleague gonna carry forward the presentation.
I'm Tanendranath Nai. Now I'm going to discuss about the features of the Thurston theory of intelligence. Thurston did not like the idea of one G factor. This is the idea of one central part that makes up total intelligence. Thurston said that intelligence cannot be one number. It has many different abilities that makes up total intelligence. Looking at someone intelligence does not show what makes a person intelligence. Looking at person's abilities shows intelligence better. Thurston's 7 primary mental abilities make intelligence. The 7 primary mental abilities are understanding words, making words quickly, comparing things quickly, remembering what we learned, and reasoning logically and imagining things in our mind. The mix up of these 7 abilities makes the person total intelligence. And the next one is the abilities are related but different. The test scores on different abilities are not very connected. This shows that abilities determine the intelligence. Researchers debate how different the abilities are. The next point is this theory likes measuring each ability separately with specific test. The specific test that has more useful information than one intelligence score. Measuring separate abilities also helps predict how well a person does tasks that use those abilities. And the next point is, Thurston believed that different people have different abilities based on which abilities they have. Many people may have expert in different areas. And the next point is, this theory, the 7 primary abilities several primary mental abilities are relatively independent of others. This means that a person can be stronger in one area and can be weaker in another area. The next point is it can be used to explain a wide range of cognitive phenomena such as intelligence test performance, intelligent academic performance and job performance. And the last point is second primary mental abilities grow at different rates in a person. The growth of one ability affects and is affected by others. The total intelligence comes from the growth of seven mental abilities. The latter part will be discussed by my colleague Sumya.
Hello everyone, I am Sumya Dendrat. Now I am covering the part of seven primary mental abilities according to Sunstone. In 1938, a psychologist known as Sunstone proposed a theory known as group factor theory to explain the intelligence in terms of primary mental abilities. Sunstone believed that intelligence is not a single entity, but rather a combination of several mental distinct abilities. These primalistic abilities forms a group. This also has own primary factor. This is known as group factor theory proposed by Sunstone. Now I am discussing the primary mental abilities by Sunstone. First one is verbal comprehension. Verbal comprehension is the ability to understand the meaning of words, concepts and ideas. It is concerned with the ability to use words, sentences, languages and verbal materials. It is measured by tests such as verbal test, comprehension test, reading test and jumble word test. It is concerned with the ability to define words. Next one is verbal fluency or word fluency. Verbal fluency or word fluency is the ability of a person to use words rapidly and quickly. It is concerned with the ability to produce words in a very short period of time. It is measured by, so like we have to examine someone to produce words, number of words in a very short period of time, starting with a particular alphabet and ending with a particular alphabet. And the third one is, that is numerical ability. Numerical ability is the ability of a person to do numerical problems and mathematical problems quickly and accurately in a very short period of time. It is concerned with the ability to mathematical operations. It is measured by checking the accuracy and speed of an individual while solving the mathematical problem. And the next one is spatial visualization. Spatial visualization is the ability of a person to mentally manipulate 2D and 3D figures. It is concerned with the ability to think and reason about objects and spaces in 2D and 3D figures. It is measured by tests such as differentiate geometric figures, solving puzzles and solving jigsaw puzzles. Suppose an example, when you are putting together a furniture, you should have to visualize and imagine the pieces into 2D and 3D figures so that the pieces will fit together and interact with each other. And next one is spatial speed. Spatial speed is the ability of a person to compare and recognize specific images, texts and objects. It is concerned with the ability to differentiate objects and substances, etc. It is measured by tests like a picture recognition. Next one is memory. Memory is the ability of a person to recall and memorize certain concepts, ideas, sentences and languages. It is concerned with the ability to memorize concept and retain them in a longer and short period of time. It is measured by tests such as the participant are asked to learn a nonsense syllabus and then examine them to remember them in a very short period of time. And the last one is, that is inductive reasoning. Inductive reasoning is the ability to make a conclusion based on certain specific events, and it is concerned with the ability to make conclusion from general to the specific. It is measured by tests such as asking the participant to identify the relationship between words and then apply the relationship in a set of words and languages and phrases. It is method-based test like as number series, word series, and etc. As an example, when you are eating peanuts, when you are eating peanuts, you say movies that you are coughing. That means you are allergic to peanuts. Here I am ending my part. In the latter part, will be discussed by my colleague.
I am going to discuss about the criticism and influence of Thurston primary mental abilities. Thurston theory emphasized the importance of specific abilities and rejected the idea that intelligence was a single unitary concept. He believed that by understanding the different primary mental abilities, Thurston theory also psychologists could gain a more exact understanding of how people think and process information. While Thurston theory has been criticized for its lack of empirical support and for its somewhat arbitrary contraction of primary abilities, it has also had some influence in understanding the intelligence level. Thurston approach has also influenced some recent theories of intelligence, such as Gardner theory of multiple intelligence, which also specified the specific cognitive abilities. Thurston theory also helpful for teachers to understanding the intelligence levels of students. Students of different primary and mental abilities through various mental ability tests and involve them in various intellectual abilities. It is commonly observed that some students are good in performing and calculating numerical problems, while others perform well in research-based subject. It is because they have a higher factor of one mental ability than the other. As different students have different mental abilities, there should be a curriculum in the educational system that everyone should show their talent in this field, and school should give them the opportunity to show to select their subject as per their strength for particular primary mental abilities.
Any questions?
Okay, I have a question that what is the difference between the primary mental abilities and the general intelligence?
In the general intelligence, Spearman's, according to Spearman's general intelligence, it's like it is hereditary. He just generalizes. For example, if a girl with a good sporty physique, according to Spearman, she can do any sports. But it's not like that. No one can do every sport. But whereas in the Thurston primary mental abilities, Thurston said that you have to build all the seven factors.
What are some of the tasks that help in spatial visualizations?
So, suppose some of the tasks like puzzles, jigsaw puzzles, and packing blocks. So, it can help us to visualize from different angles and so that we can bring together in a correct way. These are the tasks.
Thank you.
Some abilities that are connected to Thurston's use of intelligence.
Some abilities, we have verbal comprehension, then verbal fluency, then numerical ability, memory, inductive reasoning ability.
Okay. who gave the theory of primary effectiveness?
That's true.
Which profession is highly applicable for carbon frequency? The motor and new software.
Thank you.